Yes, we all have fruit now. But what made you choose, or actually, what made ABC choose to do Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde again?
I just guess I figured one more time into Lurch, but not really because I think it's because it's so relevant for today.
In what sense?
Well, with genetic engineering and all of that, that line between morality and science, God and science, are we just going to manufacture people? What are we doing?
Yeah.
I think that question is important in drugs and what they do to you.
So the concept's been updated in a sense?
Well, kind of. My character is certainly new. There was no love interest in the original. As a matter of fact, a lot of people don't know this. The original Stevenson project was a novella, and he was starving, and he wrote it in 3 days to make some money. He needed the money. Yeah. And I bet if he figured all these people were going to make it into movies, he would have taken maybe a little more time with it and created more characters, because everybody takes a lot of dramatic license with it.
Yeah, absolutely. What's Michael Caine like to work with?
Well, he's just the best. He's one of the funniest people I've ever met.
He works enough.
You know that he. You know how people, you say, well, why is he so funny? And he doesn't tell jokes, and he doesn't do that sort of thing. He's just one of these people that whatever he does, it's funny. It's very hard to describe.
He's just a natural.
A natural, innately funny person.
Robin Williams is like that. He just does funny stuff and don't even try.
You die, you fall down.
Yeah.
I'm in this bustle. I'm wetting myself in this bustle. This is not attractive.
Bustles. You like wearing bustles? Because that's something that women today don't have to wear.
That is true.
Was it uncomfortable?
Oh, boy. It was so uncomfortable, you have no idea. I felt like a quail, you know, with this huge behind and all strapped in. And it's just so... so terrible. It's so uncomfortable. And I would work, you know, 15 hours in this, get up and have back pains and everything, and I'd take it all off and go jog in Hyde Park thinking, free again. It was just, you know, we've come a long way, baby.
Where'd you do the film?
In London.
In London. And where are you from?
South Dakota.
South Dakota?
Mm-hmm.
Big town there?
Huge. It's the fourth largest city, and it has 12,000 people.
There's 12,000 people here.
That's right. It was a great place to grow up here on South Dakota, but not a lot of opportunity to get in show business. Well, you came from Cleveland. That was like a big...
Yes, I brought her with me. I'm from Cleveland.
But that's like a big city. That you had opportunities there. I mean, four people would walk in my living room, I'd be doing a number. I'd dance and sing and you know, any opportunity, you know, the Elks Club, the Lions Club, the PTA, anything. To
wow.
just get somebody to pay attention.
Yeah, that must be a tough place if you want to be in show business.
It's really tough.
Well, somebody told me about being a car hop. What is a car hop? I don't...
You don't know what a car hop is?
No, I'm sorry.
I have left a very sheltered life.
Yes. Do you know what? I don't know what a car hop is.
Three people know what a car hop is. These are all big city folks. A car hop is somebody that you drive up to the drive-in, and they come out to your car and take your order, and then they bring it out to you on a little tray. And I learned a lot of things at the car hop, most of which have nothing to do with being a car hop. You know that? You know when you're working somewhere and there's, well, you know, there are not very many people in my hometown, and not very many people go, very many of them go out to eat, so we had a lot of stand-around time. So you make up jokes and you make up stories, and you were a magician, right?
Absolutely, in Cleveland.
So, I should have called you because we made up tricks all the time.
What was your favorite trick that you made up while being a car?
Well, do you have a spoon?
Well, they put this out here. I thought we were going to eat cereal again like I did with Huey.
No, no.
But I didn't see no bowls.
Oh, no, that's right. I was a Girl Scout. I brought my own.
Oh. Ow.
First, you have to dry it off. Your spoon, I mean.
Oh, I'm going to do that. Totally caught me off guard there. Okay.
Now, what we're going to try to do is levitate this spoon.
Mm-hmm.
But you're allowed to touch it. The spoon, I mean.
Okay.
Okay, you're just going to put your finger in it. Not too good. Let me try it one more time. And you can applaud if I get it up.
Thank you.
blessing. Okay.
I'll probably just make a fool of myself. I won't even.
Well, why should you be any different than me?
Which finger did you?
This finger there, okay. And then put your thumb on the bottom, and just sort of. Great! Wasn't that fun?
Yeah, that was fun. I feel stupid, and that's what makes me laugh. Happy Days. A lot of people. How many knew? Or have ever seen a Happy Days episode with this face?
Yeah.
Is that fun?
That was so fun. Cindy Shea, I played this movie star, Cindy Shea.
Yeah.
But the problem was I was 3 months pregnant.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I go out and I do a scene and then I go, excuse me, and I'd run around the thing and get sick.
They'd
clean me up and then I'd run around. And I didn't know I was pregnant. I was just throwing up a lot. Then I found out I was pregnant afterwards.
Oh, Sandy, do you have any of the Happy Day stuff that we get some?
Oh, God.
I'd love to see if he's
just nervous.
Never mind, I'll get the girl. There's nothing to be nervous about. She's just like us, a regular person.
Hi, I'm Cindy Shea.
Thank you.
You work with a lot of fun people, Ron Howard, and you also work with Steve Martin in a more obscure project.
Yes, a long time ago we did a really strange summer replacement show. I think they were really desperate. They had no idea what to do. So they did this summer replacement show called Wow with Ken Berry.
Mm-hmm.
And it was Steve Martin and Terry Garr and myself and Carl Gottlieb. And they did all this sort of blue screen, what's it called, chroma key stuff and animated stuff. And we did crazy skits. Steve Martin, I knew then that he had to be a huge star, or he was going to get locked up. One of the two.
Well, good luck with this ABC project.
Thanks.
When is it going to be on?
Sunday night.
That's good. You all check it out. Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde, Cheryl Ladd. We'll be right back with you.